Oh boy, Razer. Guys, relax. The old Viper came out at 80 bucks. The new Viper 8K is the same price. What's the big deal? Like, why is everybody hating on this mouse? Razer updated the Viper platform. The old Viper, I'm pretty sure, is probably gonna get discontinued as it's been clearly replaced with the Viper 8K. Is 8K a little soon for its time? Yes, but there's this nice thing called Razer Synapse. Turn the polling rate down from 8,000 hertz back down to 1,000, where we all have been gaming for the past, who knows how long, the past few years probably. So if you have a problem with the 8K hertz and you're actually a real Razer Viper user, just turn the polling rate down. 8K is a new technology, or at least a new version of polling rate that most games aren't optimized for. Wait for a patch, try out the feature then. Because I can't test it, you know, with pretty much any game, but I think like Quake or something like that, but I don't play Quake, so I'm just gonna get doo-doo done. Before we continue with the video, we have a quick word from today's sponsor, Wondershare Repair. What do you do when you have a video file that is corrupted? Well, most people usually give up or even delete the file and just accept defeat. You can try Repair online and recover up to 10 videos daily if you happen to be that unlucky, hopefully not. And preview the video after its repair online with their quick repair option, free of charge, 100% secure, and no sign up needed. If the file size is just too large or the video that you are trying to recover is in a format that is not supported by the online tool, the paid Recover desktop app available for both Windows and Mac supports a ton more codecs, and there's no file limit that you can upload to Recover. And even if your video is severely damaged, there is an advanced repair video sample analysis to take care of the most damaged video files. And if you need any additional support, you can speak to one of their technical experts to help you recover your corrupted video files. This is huge for anyone who has experienced corrupted video files. It's such a lifesaver. I kid you not, being a content creator, or if you're just out and about running and gunning and shooting videos, you want to make sure that you have a way to save your files if they get corrupted. So be sure to try it on your own. Link is in the description below, and thank you again, Wondershare, for sponsoring this video. So guys, more or less, I think that this is really just a quality of life update for the Viper 8K. This mouse feels exactly the same as the previous Viper, but just better, more improved, more up to date, minus the cable. The cable sucks now. Like, the cable is not nearly as good as it was on the OG Viper, the Death Adder V2, and the Basilisk V2. Those all have far superior cables to this one, but obviously, to do that 8,000 hertz polling rate, I'm pretty sure that you needed a worse cable to do so. So I wouldn't really recommend paracording this mouse at all, to be honest, because it's probably not gonna work and you're probably just gonna have to drop back down to 1000 or 2000 hertz. But yeah, I would just use this mouse with the stock cable and get a mouse bungee and you should be fine. Since I have this brand new Viper on my hands, one thing that I will say, one thing that I did not like about the original Viper that for me was fixed in the Viper Ultimate and the Viper Mini is the side buttons. So now the side buttons on the now standard Razer Viper Ultimate, I keep calling it the Ultimate, this is not the Ultimate, on the standard Razer Viper 8K now, the side buttons to me are very easy to reach and they're only receded just a little bit and they feel uniform to the Viper Ultimate and the Viper Mini. These new V2 Razer Mouse 1 and 2 buttons do feel a little bit crispier and they sound better than the older ones as well. Here, take a quick listen compared to my Viper Mini. And the scroll wheel I like quite a bit as well. The scroll wheel is super light and responsive and I really don't have any problems with it. And this mouse is weighing in at 65 grams, so it's still very light, no issues there. The 8K hertz obviously didn't really increase the weight or anything at all. The biggest thing that changed about this mouse is just the cable. The cable is not that great, but everything about this mouse is just an improvement to the original Viper. And this is just meant to be more of an update, more so than a selling feature. Like, it's more of a, it's the Razer Viper that has up to 8K pulling rate. So it's not the end of the world that it has it, in my opinion. Is it nice to have? Are we gonna use it now? No, we can't actually. So I recommend that you drop this down to 1000 or 2000 hertz polling rate and you wait for your games to get updated to support the 8K hertz polling rate, and then you try it for yourself if you're actually a Razer Viper user and see if it works. And to me, I do think that there is a benefit to going up to, you know, this ridiculous number of 8000 hertz polling rate. Do I think it's going to make you a better player? Maybe like just a little bit. You know, just a little bit, but I do think that it's gonna make your mouse tracks more accurate and all that stuff. It's just right now, it's kind of impossible to test. I'm pretty sure that since we're getting 360 hertz monitors now, if we keep gaming at 1080p, I'm pretty sure in 2 years, we're probably gonna see a monitor that's hitting almost 500 hertz at 1080p for competitive games. Like, I'm almost positive of that. In 2 years, if we're still playing Valorant and new monitor technology comes out that goes up to 500 hertz, and we have mice that now pull at 8,000 hertz, not only are you gonna get smoother gameplay, but you're gonna get smoother tracking from your mouse, which is gonna lead to better accuracy overall. We'll have to wait and see. But guys, relax. It's just an update to the current Razer Viper landscape. It's not the end of the world, okay? But just wanna thank you guys for watching this video. If you guys enjoy, feel free to drop a like and subscribe if you guys are new to the channel as well. Kinda glad that somebody is starting to push the boundaries of technology, even if we're not ready for it yet. Man, this is the one case where now we really aren't ready for this kind of tech. But it's nothing that a couple software updates and game updates won't fix. So eventually, probably 6 months from now, we'll start to see more games. Maybe it's happened this week, I don't know. But we'll probably start seeing games add support for 8,000 hertz polling rate. I'm sure of it. You guys, relax, take care. I will see you in the next video. Cable is not nearly as good as it was. What did I just say?
You know, during the time making the video. Oh, they got a new box. These are acting different. Y'all see this? What flip is this? An origami box?
Get brave.
Like Kyle spots an enemy, I feel scared, dude. I can feel him staring in my soul.
Oh my god, this game is trash! This game is trash! I beamed him! I was on the street too! What, I have to ruin it? Just beam this guy! Did y'all see the bullet? The blood popped out of his face! How is he not dead? I would like to see you live through that in real life!
Come on! This game doo-doo! Like, there, he probably shot me in the face. I didn't die. Okay, okay.
My aim was kind of doodle right there. I can accept that death. Let's try this Aries. Okay. Okay. 8,000 hertz does not work on Valorant. This is doo-doo. Maybe he feels like he's getting a lag spike. Watch this, I'm gonna die. 8,000 hertz. Oh my god. 4,000 doesn't work either.